matter where you are in your faith. It's nurtured at First Baptist.
It feels home. The first time I came to this church, it was like I've been here forever.
Ministry to our children and as ministry to us as part of the young adult group, and so it's made our tithing even easier with time because we can see the way that it works within First Baptist.
And then now that we have kids, but just to be able to see the seeds that you can help plant in the children.
We're real happy with the leadership here.
Very happy.
People, you know, care about each other, and they also care about the community and beyond. And I like that it's, you know, a missional church too. So,
First Baptist is a very generous congregation. Through your gifts, we have helped make some very amazing ministries possible.
I like the Upward programs. I think those are, never had anything like that when I was a kid.
To know all the things that they do, the outreach programs, the missions, all of that, is just amazing how much this church does.
To make all of this and more possible, you have donated your time, your talents, and yes, your money. But did you know that most of the time our operating budget is in the red? How is that possible that we constantly struggle to meet basic expenses given the generosity of our people? Well, here's the problem, and here's how you can help.
Let's have this arrow represent our church's finances, and let's start at the point. Remember, this is going to be oversimplified, but it will do for now. This yellow tip of the arrow can represent mission giving and special offerings. This would include things like the One Great Hour of Sharing offering that goes to help people in times of crisis and natural disasters. It includes money that people give to our missionaries, like David and Laura Parajon in Nicaragua. If you want to go beyond dollars, it could even include things like Operation Christmas Child, or the food and clothing you donate for Doorstep or the rescue mission. Now, if this yellow part is the money you donate for outside groups, this purple part of the arrow can represent special programs we do here with our own members. These programs are often off budget and funded by separate donations or cash flow. This would include the immensely popular Upward Basketball and Cheerleading and the ever-growing Backpack Bash. It includes our past mission trips to Nicaragua. It includes our Wednesday family night meals. And we also need to put our mortgage on the Community Life Center here in this category as well, because all our payments on the principal come from special gifts for that purpose. Then, this blue part of the arrow can represent things like endowments and designated gifts. These types of gifts are invested with our foundation or are given with a very specific purpose. There's a long list of things we have been able to do with such money: our new prayer chapel, audiovisual equipment, the Faith Forest Cove, the Stryker coffee kiosk, new signage, things for creative arts like musical instruments and puppets, even the church library. As you can see, these three kinds of financial gifts have really done a lot of good in our church, community, and world. And here's the great news about those three categories. People are always very generous to those types of things. However, there's one more category. This bottom part is perhaps the most important, and yet it is the most neglected. It's our operating budget. This is the money that keeps us up and running. It maintains our facilities and is really the building blocks of anything we do. The majority of the operating budget is staff salaries and benefits, but there are many other essential things in here too. It includes all of our bills and utilities, as well as building maintenance. It includes program dollars. Program dollars are how we pay for things like materials and supplies for the children, books and curriculum, sheet music, food for church functions, our newsletter, advertising on the radio, flowers and cards for the sick, some of the meaningful things that we get to do. You see, the things in these other categories are often more attractive. It accounts for so many of the great resources and opportunities that we have, and people can more easily see exactly what their money is doing. But we have to have a solid financial foundation to do all these other special ministry projects. Without taking care of our operating expenses, we don't have the staff or facilities to accommodate all those other things we listed up there. Money given to all of the special offerings and causes that we mentioned above does not go toward our operating expenses. Any giving up here needs to be above and beyond what you give down here. That's why we're asking you to make sure you give from the bottom up.
All of that is just amazing how much this church does. So it's a very good place for our money to go.
I have a simple question for you. Do you consider First Baptist Church your church? Now, regardless of how involved you are or how often you're here, I mean, maybe you attend worship once every 3 months, maybe you are here several times a week, but do you consider First Baptist Church your church? If you do, here's what we're asking you to do, and here's why you're watching this video. We're asking that you commit to give from the bottom up. Now, what does that mean? What does this little catchphrase mean? To give from the bottom up means that you give regularly and consistently to the church's operating budget in an amount that equals 10% of your income, a tithe, or as close to that as you can get, with any other gifts or donations that you might give being above and beyond that amount. Now, by the way, on a personal note, I'm not asking you to do anything that I and my family don't already do. I'm one of your pastors, which means I get a paycheck, and every month we give 10% of it back. Every month. Why? Because I believe in tithing. Because it's everybody, this collective venture together called church, giving of their time and their talents and their financial resources to make it work.
Jen and I both grew up in families who were tithers, and tithing was a priority for us growing up, and so we wanted to continue that.
I was taught that you were to give 10%, and anything over that was a gift.
I said, you know, the 10% is the tithe, but everything you give above that is your offering. And so I like to start there and then kind of say, okay, now who else can we help out?
We live in what I like to call a vending machine culture. There's this expectation that you put something in and you immediately get something back out. And that's how some of these special projects and ministries work, because with some of these things, you can see an immediate need, you can immediately do something about it, and you immediately get a sense of gratification. You feel good. But it takes commitment, conscious commitment, to give from the bottom up. And when you do, you make a powerful statement against that vending machine culture and the view of the church that sees it as a vendor of religious goods and services. It's not. Church is a collaborative effort in faith formation, in ministry, where we all chip in. And when you give from the bottom up, you make a powerful statement that you don't need the allure and the feel-good nature of this one-time special project to say, I believe in ministry. I believe in my church.
Phil, it's a responsibility and it's a blessing to do, to give.
It's great to give back because, I mean, most people have more than they need, and I feel like you can always find a way to give up a little something, even though you might want the bigger or better thing. In the end, really giving back to God is more important than those things.
We read in Malachi 3:10 this verse, "Bring all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house. And prove me now in this, says the Lord, if I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out such a blessing that there will not be enough room to receive it all." God has showered us with his blessings. I encourage you to be a blessing. For 155 years, First Baptist Topeka has provided ministry to this community. I believe our best years are yet to come, and I am asking you to help be part of laying the foundation for the next 155 years of blessing and ministry. Thank you.